Dear students, welcome to the theoretical discussions in sociology. There are humpty numbers of theorists in the galaxy of sociology, of which we are trying to cover a few of the predominant scholars who contributed to the knowledge of sociology. Now we are going to talk about one such social anthropologist from Britain, who was one of the two founding fathers of British social anthropology, that is Bronislaw Malinowski, other being A.R. Radcliffe Brown. Malinowski is often presented as a man and teacher who possessed not only great intellectual ability and clarity, and not only an infectious enthusiasm for his subject and an absorbed commitment to it, but also certain idiosyncratic qualities of temperament which made him a colorful, perhaps even flamboyant personality. Malinowski was the most responsible for the creation of separate functional school and functionalism as a theory, as an opposition to evolutionism. In this unit, we are going to discuss Malinowski's contribution to sociological theory as a functional thinker. In this lesson, let us have a look on Malinowski's functionalism and Malinowski's theory of religion and magic. First, we can have a look at the glimpses of Malinowski's intellectual background. Malinowski was born in Krakow, Poland on April 7, 1884 to an academic family. He was reared in an aristocratic and cultured family with scholarly interests. His father was a college professor and well-known Slavic philologist who helped him to naturally prepare for an academic career. Malinowski spent most of his academic career at the London School of Economics. His father pioneered the study of Polish language and its folk dialects. Bronislaw's childhood was passed among the intellectuals of Krakow and Zakopane. In 1902, Malinowski went up to the Jagiellonian University. Initially, his interest was on physics and mathematics, later turned increasingly to philosophy. In 1908, he received his PhD from the University of Krakow, titled On the Principle of Economy of Thought. He was strongly influenced by Wilhelm Wundt, who turned his interest towards folk psychology and then to cultural anthropology. The preeminence of English anthropology attracted him next to London, where he engaged in research at the British Museum and pursued studies at London School of Economics. The inspiration of Westermarck and Seligman and also of Fraser, Rivers and Haddon established his anthropological interests, and in 1916, he received the degree of DSc in anthropology from the University of London. We may add that apart from the above said thinkers, Durkheim and Marat also influenced Malinowski at different stages of his intellectual career. Malinowski's writings and empirical studies were on almost all the important anthropological topics, ranging from family and kinship, magic and religion, and crime and customs among the primitive people. In his empirical or ethnographic investigations, he concentrated on one people, that is Trobriand Islanders of the South Pacific, and all his theories are based on data collected from the Trobriands. Most of his professional years were spent teaching in the London School of Economics. He died in the year 1942 while he was serving as a visiting professor at Yale University. Malinowski's most important writings on religion are compiled and edited by Robert Redfield after his death in the year 1948 as Magic, Science and Religion and Other Essays. His first ethnographic report, The Natives of Milo, in the year 1915, foreshadows the contributions to theory and method which he was to make in his later and more famous volumes of Trobriand Islanders. His work stands out in favorable contrast to his ethnographical predecessors in New Guinea area. More than 2 years of intensive fieldworks in Trobriand Islands in 1915-16 and 1917-18 enabled Malinowski to assemble the materials for those classic works of anthropological description and interpretation upon which his reputation largely rests. His works are Argonauts of Western Pacific, which was published in the year 1922, Crime and Customs in Savage Society in 1926, The Sexual Lives of Savages in Northwestern Melanesia in 1929, and Coral Gardens and Their Magic in 1935. Now we can see how functionalism is explained by Malinowski. Malinowski is primarily acknowledged as the father of branch of anthropology called functionalism. Functionalism, which is based on the notion that all the parts of society work together as an integrated whole, can be readily contrasted to the structuralism of Emile Durkheim and the structural functionalism of Radcliffe Brown, each of which place more emphasis on the society as a whole and the ways that its institutions serve and maintain it. Malinowski meanwhile placed greater emphasis on the actions of the individual, how the individual's needs were served by the society's institution, customary practices and beliefs, and how the psychology of those individuals might lead them to generate change. The crux of Malinowski's functionalism lies in the insistence upon the instrumental character of culture. Although sympathetic with the sociological concept of function as the relation of the part of culture to the rest, he preferred to employ the term in a psychological sense for the effect of an institution or complex of customs in satisfying needs. He found strong supports for his views in modern psychology. The term functionalism, however, universally applied to Malinowski's theoretical position, nevertheless labels it rather too narrowly. His emphasis might more aptly be described as scientific. He did not deny the legitimacy of historical objectives in anthropology. When he advocated so urgently the application of the methods of science to the data of culture, the scientific and the historical approaches seemed to be complementary rather than antithetical. He gave primacy to the former. However, he felt that historical interpretations, if they are to be more than inspired guesswork, must be constructed within the frame of a sound theory of culture, behavior and social structure. Malinowski always fought hard and sometimes even ruthlessly for the development of well-integrated science of human behavior. According to Malinowski, the individuals have psychological needs and the social institutions are developed to meet these needs. There are also culturally derived needs and four basic instrumental needs: economic, social control, education and political organization are the instrumental needs. These instrumental needs require institutional devices. Each institution has personnel, a charter, a set of norms or rules, activities, material apparatus, that is technology, and a function. Malinowski believed that uniform psychological responses are correlates of physiological needs. He argued that satisfaction of these needs transformed the cultural instrumental activity into an acquired drive through psychological reinforcement. Malinowski's functionalism is best discussed in the relation to the Trobriand ethnography with the aid of which it was developed. The discussion was on the distinction between magic, religion and science, which Malinowski broadly borrowed from Fraser. Though science and magic are contrasting each other based on empirical rational knowledge and reasoning from false premises, both had instrumental purpose. Malinowski deducted both science as well as magic in Trobriand society. This is connected with Malinowski's observation that while some rituals such as healing were means to an end, that is, which is scientific, others such as the festival of Millamala, which is magic related, were not. Millamala is an ancestral spirits return briefly from Tuma, the next world. Regarding the details of this belief of Millamala of Trobriandus, we can discuss in the later part of this deliberation in the theory of religion and magic. Further, the Trobrianders could give a clear reason for the former, but could not able to do that for the later, and they call it as custom. This also appeared to be the distinction between magic and religion for Malinowski, though he also grouped them together as being miraculous, mythological, and linked with emotional stress. However, this was no picture of Trobriand islanders being sunk in fear and awe for most of their lives. Malinowski regarded them as essentially practical and rational. It was only when reason and the empirical and scientific could no longer provide an explanation that magic and religion was resorted to. Thus, a Trobriander knew how to build a canoe technologically, but to cope up with the emotional stress of going on a sea voyage into the unknown, he needed magic and ritual. Similarly, inshore fishing was a purely technical matter of no great consequence, but open sea fishing required magic. Religion, on the other hand, was essentially a response to the fear of annihilation through death. While myth was important in providing a charter for present social norms and action, especially as regards the points of tension in society. For example, the fact that the matrilineal rule of descent in Trobriand society meant that a man had to support his sister's children as much as his own. Let us now discuss his contributions. To understand the theoretical explanation of Malinowski on religion and magic, first we have to know about his field, that is, where he conducted his ethnographical studies. So we can have an overview about Trobriand islanders. Malinowski's theoretical contributions were based on his field work conducted among the Trobriand islanders of North New Geneva, whose lives depend on fishing. Religious rituals occur both during the building of canoes and when the canoes put each to sea on each morning. Now we can have a look at the background of Trobriand islanders. The Trobriand islanders in the early part of the century were a matrilineal people living in the small village communities, each village consisting of group of matrilineally related men and their wives and children. The villages were linked through marriage, and throughout the island the people were united by a complex structure of reciprocal gift exchange. Horticulture and fishing in the lagoons was the principal source of livelihood. Trobriand conceptual ideas were dominated by the belief in magic and witchcraft. The witches, Mulukosi, were women who fed on carrion and know how to make themselves invisible. They flew around in disembodied form and were associated with the sea, being particularly prone to wreck men's canoes. All important aspects of Trobriand lives had their associated magical rites, the kula and garden magic being the most involved and important. Most deaths were believed to be due to magic, and though the Trobrianders admitted that illness might be due to natural causes, the final touches, or it were always put down to sorcery. Even after death, they consider a person survives. The survival was considered to be as ghost or kosi, what they call us, or as soul or baloma, they call the spirit as baloma. The soul baloma lives in the island of Tuma. which was 10 miles away from Trobriand Island. It was believed that here it lives for some more years and the spirit becomes an embryo and was carried by a Baloma woman in a basket back to the Trobriand Island of to be washed there by sea. Eventually, it entered the vagina of a woman and she became pregnant, and Trobrianders were ignorant of the physiological fact of paternity. It is clear from Malinowski's discussion, however, that the Trobriand Islanders held contradictory views about the nature of conception and were fully aware of the fact that a woman who had never had sexual intercourse could not have children. Actually, the virtual denial in the myth of father's role in procreation reflects in the matrilineal kinship pattern of the society. In Trobriander's life, there were relationship between the Baloma spirit and the living had a number of levels. In the part of their life, particularly in canoe building and yam production, these relationships were expressed in magical rites where invocations of spirits. In the harvest festival, that is Milamala, when the yams were gathered, all the Baloma spirits were believed to return from Tumma to their own matrilineal relatives and villages. The festival lasted for several weeks and there was much gift exchange, festiving, dancing and sexual licensing where platform was built for the spirits. After this festival, the spirits returned to the spirit world. Even though they believe in the dead spirit, they did not follow ancestral cult and nor considered spirits as the agents of misfortune. They also have mythical beings, but for the Trobrianders, magical beliefs plays a crucial role in their life. Now we can see his explanation on religion. According to Malinowski, people seek the assistance of gods in providing canoes which withstand storms and accessible shallow of fish. Religion thus has the function of reducing psychological anxiety which has been induced by uncertain materials of conditions of human existence. Malinowski in his important essay on magic, science and religion in the year 1925, he writes, "There are no peoples, however primitive, without religion and magic, nor are there, it must be added at once, any savage races lacking either in the scientific attitude and of in science." He stressed that primitive man had his science, a body of traditional knowledge that gave him working understanding of a natural world. For that, Malinowski suggested that no productive activities could be carried out in any society without the careful observation of natural process and a firm beliefs in their regularity and without careful reasoning, that is without the rudiments of science. Malinowski believes that preliterate people are not incurably superstitious and not immersed in a pre-logical mentality. Thus, for Malinowski, religion and science had existed since the beginning of human society. He considered religion has its sources in the individual experience. He accepted the public ritual and a social function as they are very cement of social fabric. Religion also functions indispensable for maintenance of morals. For example, funerary rites served to reassert the unity of the group. The religious rites derived their meaning only in terms of end other than rite itself. They derived their meaning only in the mythology or tradition. While explaining several religious phenomena, he touched upon aspects like sacrifice, which he considered as a form of gift giving, a sharing of food with the spirits of divinities, a ritual rooted in the psychology of the gift. Another religious aspect he talked was totemism. He considered it as both a mode of group organization and a system of religious beliefs and practices. According to him, Religious inspiration had two sources. One is the desire for immortality, and the second one is a craving for communion with God. It was based on these twin needs and gave people a sense of purpose and a feeling of peace and well-being. It gave man the mastery of its fate, whereas science was only narrowly concerned with control over the natural world. Now we can see how Malinowski explains magic. Malinowski explains magic in similar terms, stressing that it has both psychological and social functions. He was eager to argue that magical beliefs should not be equated with primitive science or with abstract concepts of power such as mana or oranda. The latter, he thought, were crude metaphysical concepts. But magic is a system of beliefs and practices that derive essential from emotional responses to situations of frustration. Magical rites and spells, though standardized and associated with an elaborate taboo system on mythology, are the outcome of emotional experiences of natural responses to those impasses in practical life when technical knowledge or control is inadequate. The magic serves to bridge over the dangerous gaps in every important pursuit or critical situation. It gives the individual a feeling of confidence and poise. He cites the fact that for lagoon fishing in the Trobriands, where man could rely completely upon his own knowledge and skill, no magic was required over there. Whereas for open sea fishing, full of danger and uncertainty, there were extensive magical rites to ensure safety and good results. Magic, therefore, is not utilized when the ends can be achieved by ordinary means. The savage never digs the soil by magic or sails his canoes by spell. That is how Malinowski states. Malinowski therefore saw an intricate and complementary relationship between science and magic, evident in all human communities, but especially clear in Trobriand and ethnography, where the two activities existed side by side, each however having a different functional role. Malinowski stressed that magic had a function in bringing order, rhythm and control into the purely technical activities like gardening or the building of sea-going canoe. Malinowski followed Taylor and Fraser in seeing magic and science as quite distinct activities. Malinowski saw magic as essentially an emotional response, viewing it like the logical positivists as virtually meaningless. It had value and meaning only in terms of psychological function, and in this religion was akin to magic. Both arise and function in the situations of emotional stress. Malinowski was a leading thinker who originated the school of social anthropology known as functionalism. Malinowski argued that culture functioned to meet the needs of individuals rather than society as a whole. He reasoned that when the needs of the individual who comprise society are met, and then the needs of the society are met. To Malinowski, the feelings of the people and their motives were crucial knowledge to understand the way their society functioned. He psychologized society, and in this lesson, to summarize, we have seen Malinowski's view on functionalism, which has psychological perspective. Then we have seen the Trobriand Island and the people of that area, where ethnographic fieldwork by Malinowski was carried out. And by analyzing them, he gave theoretical explanation about religion and magic. In the next lesson, students, we can see how he explains the functional analysis of cultural system and how the Kula ring functions in the tribal community and how it is significant in its economic activities. Thank you, students. Before closing the session, I would like to check your progress. To start with, what were the intellectual influences that Malinowski had in his younger years. And the next one is how functionalism is being explained by Malinowski, how it is different from others' explanation. Third one is write a short note on Trobriand Islanders and their living style. How magic is being explained by Malinowski. Thank you, friends. See you in the next session. Bye.